is my positioning. I'm gonna move her bangs back and take off the corner of her eyes and go straight across. And you can see I'm doing little movements. It's because I just wanna do a little bit at a time, just in case, just to stay on the safe side. I'm just trimming right in here about a quarter of an inch. Little scoops, just that tiny, tiny bit. Like this is my comb, you can see now. It's about a quarter of an inch and that's it. So now we start shaping. So I definitely wanna make sure that it's short under here. You can use a one right here and just skim in the bib if you're doing this and you wanna just put some separation from the head and the neck. So I want this to be short. I'm gonna comb her lips down and go straight across. Just gonna be really careful. Just go straight across, tiny bit. Just get her lip hairs because I want it to go straight across and then I'm gonna work my way up. Now I'm gonna set my jawline. And on this coat type, I'm gonna honor the way her coat grows. Looks like there's a little hole right here. So we'll just have to grow that in. And I won't let it ruin my day. Okay. I'm gonna take my thinning shears and just set a nice line under her chin in the smile position going up like this. And I'm only using thinning shears on her. If I want a crisper line, I'm gonna finish with my curves. But I'm just starting to shape with thinning shears. And see how the hair swoops this way? I'm gonna angle my shears and go with the grain under here. Just gonna get under here a little bit. She's been going to another groomer, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start growing in from the corner of her eye. All of this has to go up into her top knot, so I need to have this grow in, and I'm focusing on just from the bottom corner of the eye forward. So we're gonna start growing some more in and restart her shape, because someone ruined it. So I'm going under here, and I'm just setting my jawline, and then going up into the smile position. So once my jawline under here is clean, then I'm gonna just keep shaping. And Yorkie coats grow down. And for a Yorkie coat, it's really important to see the way the coat lies naturally so that you can just honor the way it grows so that you can sculpt it from there. You can't really force it to do something that it doesn't wanna do, story of my life. So I'm really just focusing on the chin first. And then I'm gonna move into the lip area and then the top of her nose, and then that's it. You always want to comb down when you're setting the length. And see, like, if I were to comb this forward, it's that's an unnatural way that it lays, and if I cut it like this, it's gonna naturally go back to this, and then it'll be too short. So I'm just gonna comb it the way it wants to go, and take the tips off going with the grain like this. And there's a little hole, so we're gonna grow this in. I don't know what happened. Maybe a crazy night at the casino, potentially. What a nice lady. Okay, so I'm just gonna stand on the side of her. The tips of the shears are pointing right at me, and I'm kind of rolling a little bit. So now that my chin length is set to what I want it to be, I'm gonna go from her lip hair straight across like this, and this will help me create a pretty smiley line. Careful of her tongue. Dogs lick out and up and out to the side, so I'm just gonna be really careful. I'm gonna put my thumb right in front of her mouth, just like this, so that she can't lick the blade. And now what we have here is line and then up. Line and then up. It kind of looks like a half moon. What does it look like?
Like a bagel.
Like a bagel? Okay, so we're gonna go with a half bagel. This is the half bagel look. I'm just shaping, and you could just notice the way I point my shears up, and then I'm gonna point my shears back. And what this is gonna do is make the coat grow in up and back. So when it grows in, it's really beautiful. So everything starts with the corner of the eye. So definitely don't trim above the corner of the eye. You see right here? I need my top knot to start from way up here. Because look at the difference in the eyes. This looks a lot more open. And then this one, if you cut it down here, you can just see like it's just a less elegant look. So I really need to grow this piece in so that it's a more elegant, beautiful look. This just makes it look heavy. That's the end of it. Oh, take a moment. Okay, so now that the chin is how I like it, it's like a U shape. Just pretend this little piece is here. Only look at this side. It's a U shape and pretty short on the bottom. I like it really short on the bottom. Okay, going up into the smile position here and right here. Taking the edges off with a really fine thinning shear. And then I'm just gonna go straight across the top. You can use curves or thinning shears here. I'm gonna comb everything up and away from the nose. Go straight across right here. And I'm just gonna chomp, chomp on my thinning shears until the line is created. And you can do curves here. And I'm not gonna go down. Gonna go down just like up until here and that's it. And up here, I'll just take these edges off. But the minute I start to go down on these edges, I'll make her look more frowny. You just wanna keep it up and pointed towards the dog like this. I'm fine. So it's kind of like if you look at the center as the nose, it's kind of like an oval. And you could do a circle, you could do kind of a heart shape, you could do whatever shape you think is cute. See when she closes her eyes? See when she closes her eyes, her coat changes? So I have to memorize what I really need to trim. So just be careful when the dogs close their eyes. Gonna take the edges off a little. If I just take these edges off, I'm softening that edge a little bit so it's not as harsh and just soft.